Hi everyone, it's Becca, and today I'm back on behalf of Wild Orchid Crafts, the Wild Bunch, to share another project with you guys, so I hope you enjoy.
Okay, so today's project is actually for the design team challenge for the month of September, and the theme was back to school. And as you guys know, I have just finished university, so I'm not going back to school anytime soon. And I actually don't have any children around so that I could make something for school as such. So I thought what I would do is make myself a notepad. And because I needed a new one, I just thought I would go ahead and decorate one for myself. So this is what it is here. And this notepad was actually just a ordinary notepad. It's an A5 notepad and it was just completely pink. The cover was just plain. I actually was looking for something like this in the craft color, but I couldn't find something with a hard cover. So I just decided to go for pink because it is my favorite color after all. And so here's what I've done. So I covered the covers with paper. And this paper right here is actually from the London Market collection by Pink Paisley. If I get a little bit closer, you guys might be able to see. So this is the one with the butterfly. And I have decorated the front cover and the back cover with the same paper. So this is what the front looks like. And then here's the back. So it's the same paper. And then for the inside of the cover, I have used a different paper, but I will show you that in just a minute. So what I've decided to do was I've decided to create a belly band, and this is what you can see here, so that it holds the pad together. And this right here that you can see, actually I'm going to turn it around so that you guys can get a better look at this. This is actually a headband, and I bought this thinking about using this for crafts anyway. And as you guys can see, it has loads of tiny beads, so it's not really the sort of thing that you want to cut into, because I do think the beads would just fall apart and just come undone. So I needed to use this as a whole, and so that's what I came up with. So as a belly band, what I did was the elastic band was a little bit too big, so I just trimmed that off a little bit. And then to cover up the elastic, I just added these beautiful deep ivory gardenias. And they look so stunning. And so this is how it just comes off. And if I show you the inside, I didn't actually glue all of the flowers to the elastic because the elastic still needs to stretch a little bit. So I glued one flower to one side, the other flower to the other side. And then the center flower is actually glued to the two other flowers. So when it's off, that's what it looks like. So then when you stretch it, it looks right. So I did that measuring the size of the pad anyway, so that it would fit perfectly. So here I've used the white Guyper lace from Wild Orchid Craft. I trimmed it a little bit so that I could use the scalloped end right here. And then here's just the trim from my stash. Then here on top, I have added this beautiful frame that I had in my stash, and I added this vintage image right here. And then I added some glossy accents so that it looks really nice and shiny. Then right here, I've used some seam binding, and this is the Cameo Beige seam binding from Wild Orchid Craft. And then in the center here, I've used the silver ribbon buckle and then the pearl ribbon buckle in the center with a pearl in the center here. And then here on the corner, I have added these beautiful little flowers. So here I've got a variety of lilies and sweetheart blossoms. So these are the lilies, and this is the baby pink. And then the sweetheart blossoms, which is these tiny little flowers that you see scattered around, they're actually from the mixed color pack. And then in the center here, I've got another one of those silver buckles and also a pearl buckle inside it, and then the pearl in the center. And then here, what you can see here, this is actually my page marker. And the way I've done this is, of course, the actual ribbon is, again, the seam binding is the same color, the Cameo Beige. And then on the back here, I have used two corner pieces from Wild Orchid Craft, and these are the silver filigree corner pieces, and basically I just glued these two together so that it would form this sort of diamond shape. And then I actually added one of these cute little doves, and this is from Wild Orchid Craft as well. This is one of the wood embellishments that Wild Orchid Craft sells, and this is the dove, and it's just so cute. So I'll show you how it works. So obviously it dangles here at the front because I wanted it to be decorated. So when you pull this up, here is the page marker. So say if I wanted to mark this page because this is where I'm at, I can just put this here, close it, and then dangle at the front. I didn't want it dangling down here because I knew it was gonna bother me. So because I was making it myself, I just thought I would do something that suits me. So that's what I done. So I will show you how I've done that in just a moment because it's stuck to the back. So here, I'm just going to show you what I've done to the front cover here on the inside. I haven't really done much. I just covered it with paper because I wanted to cover up the ends of the paper from the front. So the paper from the front have been folded in the corners, and then I wanted to cover that up. So I just used this beautiful paper, and it's again from the same collection. So this is from the London Market by Pink Paisley. And then right at the back, I actually used the same paper again, the flowery one, as you can see here, but I also have created this beautiful little pocket here, and I've just created this using cardstock, and I've created like a fold here on the side so the envelope expands. So if I just show you guys here, this dangly charm right here is this beautiful little butterfly, and this is from the mixed pack of metal embellishments from Wild Orchid Craft, but they also sell some packs of butterflies separately. So if you don't want to get the mixed pack, you can also get the butterfly pack. So anyways, I've tied this to this little string here so that it creates a closure here for my little pocket. And if I open this up, this is what it looks like on the inside. And I didn't bother covering up the brad because, you know, it's mine anyway, so I didn't really mind doing it like that. So here is the envelope or the pocket. So as you can see here, it expands so that it can fit more. But of course, I don't want to put too much in this pocket because otherwise the notepad is going to be a little bit bulky. So this is just for little bits of things that I might need to add in here. So that's what the pocket looks like, and I just added this beautiful doily here on the lid of the pocket. And of course this page marker here, I have glued it down before I even glued down the back paper. So you can see it's sandwiched in between so that you can see the end. So that's basically how that works. And this is my design team challenge for this month. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you have any questions, please let me know. And as always, I will have all of the product codes down below in the description bar so that you guys can go ahead to the Wild Orchid Craft website and check them out. And I will also add the Facebook page for Wild Orchid Craft as well as the YouTube channel so that you guys can go and check that out as well. So thanks so much for watching. I will catch you next time. Bye.